attacking spirit as Richie Porte now goes for it, as he just used up two of the attacks now. Tomansky is then a clever move by Porte. Well, Tomansky's looking behind him to see who else is going to do the chasing. Richie Porte is off up the road, he's got about 10 bike lengths. Tomansky, I don't think he's got him in the tank to go after them. One attack too many, Sean.
Into a win at the race. Up to start, our leader Richie Porte, trying to become the first ever rider from the Southern Hemisphere to win Paris-Nice. He knows this climb probably better than anyone in the field. Again, rides it three or four times in the overall ride today.
He was embarrassed at the first couple of days of this bike race wearing number one because he inherited that from Bradley Wiggins, who was the defending champion. He decided not to participate in Paris-Nice this year. And you might just notice he's opted for the modern era because he's got a race radio in his back. That will give him the information of the time splits out on the course. He will know that
by 32 seconds in the overall standings. There you see the Australian flag on the back of Porte's helmet. He's from Tasmania, part of Australia, and looking to become the first Australian winner of the Race to the Sun.
Yes, a lot of people call Tasmania the little island off the big island, although let's never forget that Australia is a continent. Good cadence here as well. You can see that he's really bunched up as a bike rider. He's got himself almost into the form of a rocket at the front end of his body. A lot of run
to Richie Porte, final man on the course. Consider the fatigue too, Paul. Remember, they did 18 climbs in the last Richie Porte. Last year in this Coldez final time trial uphill at Paris-Nice, he was 28, 144 behind Brad Wiggins, but the circumstances were much different. He had been working the entire race as a helper to Wiggins. He was tired. He wasn't going for the win, so it's hard to use that as a yardstick considering how much is at stake today.
Well, he wouldn't have had the motivation last year because he knew that Paris-Nice was in the bag for his team leader, Bradley Wiggins. He will have just ridden this time trial just to get it done and dusted and out of the way. This is a different ballgame. He's got a yellow jersey on his shoulders. He knows if he can ride well in the individual.
Here is Richie Porte, and he has gone through the intermediate checkpoint with a new best time ahead of American Andrew Talansky.
By 21 seconds, he's not showing any fear or trepidation, just concentration on that face of Richie Porte here this afternoon. As he looks up the road, he now knows he's only got around about 4.5 kilometers to write his name into the record books.
So a big gap at the top, and at that interval, 5.5 kilometers into the course. 6 miles altogether, that's 9.6K. So halfway through, Richie Porte looking good, adding to his margin. Remember, he started the day, been laser-like in his focus for this time trial on his home roads and a hill, a course he knows intimately well.
As you see now, we've got to the flatter part. We're just looking around each one of these corners for the finishing line. He's up onto his big chain ring as well now as he got himself right over to the smaller sprockets on the right-hand side. Over these final few hundred meters, he's going to pick it up to 40 kilometers an hour, 25 miles an hour of racing, when most of this climb he's only been doing 17 or 18 miles an hour.
Richie Porte The 28-year-old won on the Montagne de l'Ours Summit finish a few days ago. That's when he moved into the yellow jersey as overall race leader for this very powerful Team Sky. And now look at this time as he comes around the final turn. He is going to win his second stage of this year's race. And this is going to be the biggest overall win of his career. Richie Porte wins the time trial and Paris-Nice overall.
22 seconds. Look at his eyes here just as he comes up to the finishing line. He's looking at us on the banner over the finishing line, and that's when he starts to smile a fraction, because he knows he's not only won Paris-Nice, but he's won the final stage as well.
And that's the way to do it, putting the exclamation point. The guy who wore the Maglia Rosa, the pink jersey at the Giro d'Italia a few years ago, wound up winning the white jersey as best young rider of that race. But today, it's the yellow jersey of Paris-Nice that is the biggest jersey of his young career so far as he wins the overall. Wins this race, Paul, and now he will go back to being a helper for Bradley Wiggins and in a support role at the Giro d'Italia this year as Wiggins goes for the Giro title.
Just looking at the line there, that's the same line that they hand out for stage victories at the Tour de France, and that line is the symbol of LCL or Le Crédit Lyonnais Bank of France, who have been a long-time sponsor of the Tour de France and, of course, of this race too.
Cadell Evans, if he